Absolutely spectacular and a perfect prison for volcano watchers as this occurred on Christmas Eve. What you are looking at are a series of towering lava fountains which harmlessly erupted away from any structures at Hawaii's Kilauea Volcano through the night and early morning of December 23rd and 24th. Two vents erupted, with the south vent reaching a whopping 1,400 feet into the sky, while the north vent ejected molten rock to heights of just under 1,000 feet. That means that lava ejected from the south vent was initially thrown upwards at speeds of 204 miles per hour, being propelled upwards by the rapid expansion of gas within the molten rock as it got close to the surface. Ignoring air resistance, ejected lava fragments would take a full 18.6 seconds to reach the ground. And while the actual eruptive rate during these tallest lava fountains was higher, an average of 472.14 cubic meters per second of lava erupted across the nearly 6 hours of continuous lava fountain that was observed. In total, 10 million cubic meters of basaltic lava erupted in the southwestern edge of Kilauea's summit caldera, marking a number of high points for an eruption that began exactly 1 year before the latest eruptive episode commenced. Episode 39, the specific episode number which just occurred at Kilauea, ranked 37th in terms of its duration. And yet, it ranked 3rd in terms of total volume of erupted lava, 2nd in terms of the peak sustained lava fountain height, and 1st in terms of its average lava effusion rate. In other words, this eruptive episode was special. Only on a handful of occasions during the last century has any Hawaiian volcano produced towering lava fountains exceeding 1,000 feet in height. Large volumes of the ejected lava eventually fell back to the ground, producing a series of bright glowing 1,200 degrees Celsius or 2,192 degrees Fahrenheit lava flows, which would go on to cover two-thirds of the caldera floor. You might be wondering what the aftermath of V3cam looks like as it was destroyed by episode 38's lava fountains. Well, this photo should answer your question as it lies buried beneath 10 meters or 33 feet thick of lava and tephra. However, the US Geological Survey deployed a replacement V3cam 1,100 feet further to the east on December 19th, with this being footage from the new camera's vantage point. Kilauea's episodic activity, which began 1 year ago, has followed this fairly predictable cycle now 39 times, always ending in hours-long periods of sustained lava fountaining. Episode 39 was preceded by overflows of degassed lava that began at approximately 6:41 p.m. on December 23rd from the south vent and continued to increase in intensity until 8:20 p.m. when sustained lava fountaining began. The north vent's lava fountain was initially higher, but it did not take long for the south vent's counterpart to surpass it, with this occurring around 8:25 p.m. The twin lava fountains then rapidly grew in height, soon reaching their peak height only an hour into the eruption. Afterwards, a slow but continuous reduction in height occurred until the north vent ceased erupting at 2:01 a.m. on December 24th, with the south vent ceasing 12 minutes later. While the amount of lava Kilauea's recent eruptive episodes have produced has continued to increase, so has the average amount of time between each eruptive episode. As a result, if this trend continues, I expect Kilauea's 40th episode of sustained lava fountaining to begin sometime between January 4th, 2026 and January 18th, 2026. If you are wondering how much shallower portions of Kilauea's caldera floor has gotten since exactly 1 year ago, the answer is up to 528 feet shallower. It will take another 6 eruptive episodes for Kilauea's ongoing phase of activity to surpass its all-time historical record measuring the number of intermittent episodes of lava fountaining an eruption has produced. Thanks for watching. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Bruce Javidan, for supporting my work.